Hello everybody, Mr. LEGOLover55 here, and welcome to another LEGO set review. Today we're taking a look at another LEGO Minecraft set. This is The Cave. This is set number 21113. This is recommended for ages 8 and up, and it has around 249 pieces. So, here on the front of the box, we've of course got the LEGO Minecraft logo with the creeper face here, and then we've got all the minifigures and figures included in this set. So we've got Steve, Zombie, and a Spider. And it also here says that you can build your own creations, inspiration included. And then here on the back, it pretty much shows all of the things that you can do here. So you can mine ores, and then here it shows all the blocks that you can get. So there's TNT, gold ore, coal ore, iron ore, and redstone ore. It also says that you can create your own creations once again. But that's pretty much it for the box. So let's go ahead and open this thing up and see what's inside. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and open it up using one of these, because who needs a knife when you've got one of these? Alrighty, just gotta do that, and I think I'm kind of cutting into the box instead of the, okay. This is pretty tight. Oh, there we go. Alrighty. And we shall dump out all of the pieces, or bags in this case. Alrighty, put the box off to the side, and I will go, let's see, so we've got an instruction booklet, quite a large instruction booklet. We have bag one, and we have bag two. So this is all the stuff that we get in this set. So I'm going to go ahead and build this, and I'll be right back with you once I'm done so we can take a look at the instructions. Okay, so we'll go ahead and take a quick look here at the instructions. So pretty much here on the front is pretty much the same stuff as on the front of the box. Next page, it shows that you should organize your pieces according to the numbered bags. Then, of course, we've got the building instructions. And then we have the final product here at the end. So there's the final product. But then there's instructions for an alternate build. So you could actually take parts off the set and rebuild that into something else. And in this case, it would be that. So next page shows just a little information about the game of Minecraft. So yeah, cool little picture there. This little poster here, for the release of Minecraft, in 2014. All of the LEGO Minecraft 2014 sets, so yeah, this is an older set, so, I do have some of these sets, still. I have the farm, I just kinda got that last year, actually, I think. I got the crafting box, and I got the mine. This was actually the first LEGO Minecraft set I got, so, yeah. And then once again, it shows the sets again, but this time it actually shows, like, the minifigures and stuff that are included, and the ores and blocks and all that. Then here, it shows a little advertisement for the LEGO Minecraft website, and then an advertisement for the LEGO Club, which is unfortunately no longer with us. It is now LEGO Life, so it's kind of funny that it was just a few years ago it was LEGO Club, and now it's LEGO Life, so kind of funny. And then our good old list of pieces. And that is pretty much it for the instructions, so let's go ahead and take a look at the cave. Okay, now I'm going to be completely honest, I'm not going to really take the time to take a look at all of the minifigures here, because one, they're pretty much the same minifigures we've been getting for the past few years now, so Steve is pretty much Steve, nothing new about him, same print on the front, just those four pixels there, he comes with an iron pickaxe, that's nothing new. So yeah, that's Steve, and then we've of course got the zombie, and he's, once again, pretty much like any other zombie you would get in a LEGO Minecraft set. So similar to Steve, four pixels here on the front for printing, nothing on the back, green head, just, yeah, purple pants, all that, nothing new there. The spider, this is actually my second spider I've ever gotten, so this is actually kind of nice to get another one. But yeah, the spider has pretty much just been the same as it's been. Actually, I think the ice spikes changed the design a little bit, but just barely changed it. Instead of having there be two tiles there on the top, it's just one 2x3 tile there on the top for the new new spider design. So yeah, nothing really too special about these minifigures. We've got them all before in different types of sets, but yeah, so that's pretty much it for the minifigures. I'm actually just going to go ahead and take them out here for now. And yeah, let's go ahead and actually take a look at the cave here. So you can see it's quite a small set, but there's actually quite a lot of stuff in this. So, well, I guess we'll start here up at the top. So here we have a chest, and in that chest there is a piece of bread, just one of those large loaf pieces, and of course, with that in there, the chest won't close fully, so you have to take it out if you want to close it fully, so kind of disappointing, but it's been like that for quite some time. Then we've got a ladder here going down to the, I guess, actual cave system, and we have a bucket of lava here, and now they actually do give you another sud, so if you want to, you can change that out to be a bucket of water, but I have the lava in there just because I have plenty other buckets of water that have come in other sets, so I'm gonna keep that as a bucket of lava. And then, of course, where the place you would collect that water or lava is right here, so you can see the water and lava are actually merging together to form obsidian, so that's pretty neat as well. And also, you can see scattered throughout this set, there are several ores, so over here we have a gold ore. There's also a gold ore right here, a piece of redstone ore right back there in the back, you can kind of see it. And then that's pretty much it there, but then there's more over here. So we've got actually two pieces of coal ore right there, and then an iron ore there, so that's pretty neat. And then you've of course got some grass blocks and all that, and of course there's the TNT block. Nothing new about this, but it's always nice to get more TNT because... let's all admit it, I'm sure all of us who have played Minecraft have at one point just gone into creative and just tried to blow up a world. I'm sure all of us Minecraft players have done that at some point, but yeah. So anyway, something I actually really do like about back here is that all of these little blocks are on jumper plates, so if we just turn this around, you can actually get a better look at this. So all these are stacked onto, I guess, more blocks. So you've got some stone blocks here, which are stacked on top of a red stacked on top of ores. Then we've got some more stone blocks. And you can see there's jumper plates right here. So I guess if you want to, you can get other sets and kind of expand right here. So you can have, this can be like a cave opening. So like you're mining ores and you find a whole new larger cave, I guess, so it's pretty neat how you're able to do that. And then it's of course also like this on this side. You can take those out, so yeah, very neat how they were able to do that. You could also do the same thing over here, except I think over here is not, wouldn't really go be an entrance to another cave. I would actually think this is the entrance to this cave, so yeah, you can take off these grass blocks, and of course take off these ores and all that, so yeah, very neat how you're able to do a lot of customization with this, with all these jumper plates, and that was kind of the main focus of these older Minecraft sets, to kind of take apart and rearrange, I guess. Now it's mainly about, I guess, modularity, I guess, so having, like, modular parts of the build, and you could rearrange those instead of just a I guess, singular blocks like that. But, yeah, so there really isn't a whole lot else I have to say about this main build. However, we will go ahead and take a look at the alternate build, which, it's honestly not all too impressive, but we're gonna take a look at it anyways. Okay, so here is the alternate build that you can create with the pieces in this set. So, now, over here, there really isn't a whole lot of changes here. You actually just took off the top part right here, and then the water part right here, and basically just took all those apart and rebuilt them into this little thing over here. And looks pretty neat. I guess it's supposed to be like a bridge going over water, maybe like a lake or something, and then going, I guess, to another part of the cave. Although it's a little bit confusing because I thought this would be like, this should be like the outside or something. I don't know. Maybe this is the outside and there's like a river. Maybe these are like mountains or something going up and there's a river in between them. Build a bridge over them and then there's another cave on this other mountain. I don't know. You kind of have to use your imagination with that. But yeah, there really isn't a whole lot else. It just connects here onto that jumper plate right there. So this is pretty much what you have. And what you're left over with, they didn't actually tell you where to put this chest. However, there are of course plenty of places on here that you can, but it's, you can put it, like, maybe somewhere over here, or if you want to, whoops, you can maybe put it on one of these jumper plates or something. I don't know, there's several different places you can put it if you want to, but, yeah, there really isn't a whole lot else to this build, so I think we'll go ahead and get on to the end of the video. Okay, so before we go over my final thoughts on this set, we can take a look at some of the extra pieces included in this set. So we get quite a few. So we get some 1x1 plates in light bluish gray. We actually get three of those, so that's pretty nice. We also get some studs, of course. We get a lot of studs. We get a black 1x1 stud. We got one in this light tan color. We got one in trans blue, an orange, gold or pearl gold, and trans red. And then we also get two more other 1x1 plates. So we got one in trans yellow and one in trans orange. We also get one of these little, I guess, pieces for the bucket. So yeah, one of those in this, I guess, dark tan color. And we got one of these tea pieces in black, which those are always nice to get in that color. I remember, I think the first set I ever saw those in was a Bionicle set. I think it was Hydraxon, because that was the first set I think I saw that had actually really cool fingers. But yeah, enough of that. So time for my final thoughts on this set. So overall, as a $20 set, I don't think it's worth it. However, I got this for $15, of course, because this has been a set that has been available since 2014, and for some reason it's still on shelves, at least for me, and I got it for $15, so pretty much I got it for 25% off since it's just been available for so long. And I'll say I think you're getting a good deal for $15, because that's really the price of a Minecraft skin pack or a minifigure pack or whatever, and I think that is this is a good deal for $15. Of course, it'll vary from what places you'll be able to get it for. There's just, yeah, prices will vary, I guess, but since I did get this for, I guess, $15, I think it's a worthy price of that. There really isn't a whole lot of, I guess, play features other than just building and rearranging stuff and making your own creations as stated on the box. But yeah, there wasn't really any play features with these sets back when the first wave of LEGO Minecraft sets came out. But so yeah, but of course a lot of the Minecraft sets nowadays have really cool well hidden, I guess, play features. So yeah. But, yeah, the figures in this set obviously aren't all too great. We get a spider, zombie, and Steve. Just very, very basic figures included in this set. The accessories, I think, are nice. My favorite part about the accessories is that you just get a whole lot of ores in this set. You get, like, two gold ores, two pieces of gold ore, a redstone ore, two pieces of coal ore, one iron ore, and a redstone, or not a redstone block, TNT block. So you do get a whole lot of, I guess, little accessories. You also get the chest, the piece of bread, the lava bucket, or water bucket. You could, of course, change that out. And an iron pickaxe. The iron pickaxe isn't all that exciting since we've gotten plenty of those in other sets, but it's still a nice thing to get, I guess, just to collect more pickaxes, I guess. As a playset, I don't think this was a really good one. However, I think this is actually a really good display set. So maybe if you're, like, building a LEGO Minecraft world or something, I think this is a really good addition to that. So, like, if you're making, like, a cave or something, I would definitely recommend getting this for that. But there really honestly isn't a whole lot else I have to go over with this set. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and keep building!